Hello, welcome to my talk about the new garbage collector, which is named Shenandoah. Well, my first question is, who knows anything about garbage collectors in Java? Ah, okay. It would be difficult, I think. Okay. So, let's begin. Shenandoah is a new garbage collector, which is now developed in Red Hat by Christine Flute and Roman Kinke, and there are very, very active on this project, and at this moment the Shenandoah garbage collector is from my point of view stable, and we are doing some benchmarking to compare it against the other garbage collectors which are already included in JDK. And the other thing is that Shenandoah is no open source it, and if you are interested in it, you can get sources from Mercurial repo, from istclass.org. Am I right? I think, yeah. So the goal of Shenandoah is to provide ultra-low pause time when the garbage collector tries to manage Java heap, and the pause time should be proportional to the size of the root set. I will show you what the root set is on the next slide, and the other goal is to have very low pause times, usually less than 10 milliseconds for very large heaps, which can be larger than 100 gigabytes to 1 terabyte or so. So what's the size of root set? I think that that you know how heap looks like in a Java virtual machine. There's a heap, and there's a there are some stacks. Usually, the stack is created for each thread in Java. So if you have some application which has 10 threads, for example, then you have 10 stacks, and the root size is basically the content of this stack, content of stack frames, and also content of static variables, which are initialized when some class is loaded. So this is the size of root set, and the goal of Shenandoah is to have pause times which are based only on the size of the root set, and not the count of object on heap, which is different from most other garbage collectors. Well, the other goal for the future version of Shenandoah is to have a pauseless garbage collector. It's a long-term goal, and at this moment there are no garbage collectors which are truly pauseless. So every garbage collector which is included in JVM must stop all threads during some operation, and Shenandoah tries to minimize these times, and the long term goal is to minimize it to zero time. Let's hope it's possible. I'm not sure. Well, the basic Shenandoah features is that it tries to stop other threads only during the scan of root set. It means that Shenandoah needs to stop Java threads when it tries to read the contents of stack. I mean the stack frames. This is the only time when the other thread are stopped for some time, and then other operations runs in parallel with the Java thread. The Shenandoah is based of concurrent and parallel marking. It means that the object on a heap are marked, are scanned and marked when the Java program runs. So there are no stop. The marking runs in parallel and in concurrent. And which is very interesting, the evacuation, which is the copying object or moving object in heap, runs in parallel to. So Java threads don't have to be stopped at this moment, and objects are moved, and the other threads usually don't care. And fourth feature is that there are no card tables. I'm going to talk about card tables. These are data structures used in other garbage collectors to synchronize content of young and tenured generation on heap. Well, Shenandoah is a bit different from the classic generational garbage collectors. The classical generational garbage collectors is based on hypothesis that most objects die young. This means that most objects are, for example, created in one method, and then the object could be deleted from the heap, which might be true, and this hypothesis has been used for a long time, but it looks like that for some optimized applications it's not common. So generational garbage collectors uses divides heap into two generations, into young and old generations, and objects are allocated in almost all objects are allocated in the young generation area. And this might be enough for older computers with only one CPU, but when you have computers with more CPU or more cores, you need to be able to allocate objects in parallel. Each thread needs to allocate many objects, and to solve this issue, the so-called thread local allocation buffer is created for each thread, and objects are allocated are created in this memory area. This is created for each thread. And in this area, objects are created, are compacted. This means that to allocate some memory amount, you just need to add some offset to the pointer which points to the first free word in memory. This is very fast and much faster than malloc in C, for example, or new in C++. So generation garbage collectors divided heap into the young generation and tenured generation. The young generation consists of so-called add-in, where objects are created, and two so-called server spaces. The tenured generation is just one big area of memory, nothing else. Well, in current versions of JVM, we have usually three types of generation garbage collectors. There are serial collector, which is good for smaller heaps, and it does young and full collection with the stop the word, which means that all the threads needs to be stopped when the collection occurs, and other threads needs to wait for garbage collector to finish. And this collector is pretty good for systems with only one or two cores, because it's very easy to implement and very easy to run. But for most machines, the parallel collector is better. It's focused on multi-core machines with larger heaps, and it's in many things similar to serial garbage collector, but uses more GC threads to collect memory. The third type is concurrent collector, which makes most work in parallel in many threads, and it's also focused on larger heaps. And interesting is that is it used so-called work stealing, which means that there are, for example, 8 garbage collector threads, and there are some queue of work which needs to be done, and each thread gets some work from this queue. And there are similar technique used in Shenandoah. So how compaction generational garbage collectors works? There are the EDN and two server spaces in queue generation. New objects are created in EDN when these objects are small enough to fill in EDN. When the EDN is full, the first step is to copy all objects into the one of the server space. And when the server space is filled by objects, then the second step is to copy and compact the objects into the second space. The compaction step is very easy because the server space is empty, so only live objects are copied here or moved here, and this is why the compaction is for free here. So how garbage collectors behave in a runtime? The sequential or serial garbage collectors is very easy. There are some Java threads, which means there are threads created by your Java application. The threads needs to be stopped where garbage collectors begins to do some work, and then only one garbage collector threads do the compaction and remove unused objects, and after it finished its work, then Java threads are resumed and they can continue to work, to run. Parallel garbage collectors is similar. It stops all the Java threads at some point, and then garbage collector threads are run. So this is better for machines with multi-cores, with 4, 8 or so CPUs. Concurrent mark and sweep is quite different, because there are some GC threads which runs in parallel all the time. And Shenandoah is similar to concurrent mark and sweep, with the exception that it do compaction of heap every time. And why is compaction important? for garbage collectors, because it allows us to do pointer map, to do allocation of memory by simple pointer bumping, which is very easy. You don't have to look into the heap where is free space with the right size and so on. This is very easy. And how Shenandoah would do this work? It's based on marking and compaction of the heap while all the Java threads are running. They don't have to be stopped. But as I show on a previous slide, the other garbage collectors usually stop all the Java threads during the garbage collecting. And this is a big problem, the stop the world behavior. There's a simple diagram. Who knows what Amdahl's law is? Okay. This is the diagram of a simple Java benchmark, which runs on many CPU cores, and there are the first iteration runs on only one CPU core, the next on two, and so on, and the limit is 32 cores. The garbage collector, either serial or parallel, took 10% of computer time, only 10% only. And there are the real speed up. And as you can see, for the machine with 32 CPU cores, the speed up is not 32 times of the original speed. It's only, I don't know, seven times more. So here you can see that only 10% time spent on garbage collector maybe showstopper for some applications which are truly parallel. And now the hard thing, how can we mark and move object in heap when the other threads are running and there are trying to read object attributes, write into object attributes, and so on. This might be hard, and because the garbage collector could copy the object into other region, other place in heap, and we need to be able to have only one active copy of such object. And there are two options. We could create some memory protection traps when some thread tries to access some memory area to read or write. We can just throw some exception and work with it, or we could add some level of indirection, which means that the object usually don't point to other object, to some attributes, but they point to other pointer. And this is the base for Shenandoah. It uses this one level of indirection, one additional level of indirection. And it's based on so-called forwarding pointers. I will talk about them on the next slide. And when these forwarding pointers are added to each object on head, we have one level of indirection which can be used during the object read or write. And by using this forwarding pointers, we don't have to use remembered sets, and we don't have to use any hardware to trap writing or reading into memory. So this is a software only solution, which is good because it can be used on many types of hardware. Well, remembered sets. Do you know what is it? Andrew, yeah, okay. The problem with the classical generational garbage collectors is that when you move some object in younger generation, which is pretty fast, you need to keep track of this object on other objects which could point or reference these objects in the old generation. And this is the main problem for most generational garbage collectors, because they need to synchronize the young generation object with the old generation. And classical generational garbage collectors uses core tables. It's I have some graph on the next slide, and G1 garbage first collector uses remembered sets to remember objects which needs to be updated in the old generation. So how generational GC works with cards? It's quite easy. We have the two server spaces in old generation, and when some objects are moved from to region, the corresponding object in the old generation needs to be updated. For example, there are some object which contains attribute of type string, for example, and then string could be updated simply by adding another string to it. And garbage collectors keeps tracks of this object in card tables. This is the card table is very easy. It's just a bit set, and when some bit is set to one or to true, then the corresponding objects needs to be updated. So this means that even when generational garbage collectors do the compaction of young generation, it still needs to update some objects in old generation. And this might be a problem for large applications, because when the application is really large and multi-threaded, then the card table will be filled by many ones, and it slows down the garbage collecting. To solve this issue, the original garbage first collector use remembered sets. These are sets of pointers which points to some region of the old generation. On the other hand, Shenandoah don't need to use these remember sets. It simply removes them, and we have only some regions and some live data in it, nothing else. Well, forwarding pointers are based on Brooks pointer, and it was used in some Lisp interpreters. Who knows Lisp? Ah, no. Andrew, for example. Yeah. It's quite simple. We have some object stored in heap, either in young or old generation. It doesn't make sense. And there are pointer added to this object. This is simple simple an address which might point to this object or to some other region. Nothing else. This means that by using the forward pointers, the structure of object on heap don't have to be changed, which means that the object format is still the same, and we can use most tools which can walk the heap and do some operations on heap. J-head, for example, or I'm not sure about thermostat, but probably it uses the same technology. But it's, it remains the same, the format of this object. It's very simple. There are some mark word, type of object is stored there, and length of array, and so on. Well, and the forward pointers are used during the moving object from some regions from heap to other regions to keep track of the live object, because we need to synchronize the garbage collectors threads with other threads, with so-called mutators. It looks like this. There are object B stored in some heap, and this object is not to be moved. It's still on the same position, and the forwarding pointer points to the same object. The object A is different. It's been moved by the garbage collector thread or the mutator thread to the other region, and now we have two same objects at the beginning, but only the object moved to the new region is active, and every writes or reads to this object needs to be performed here, not on the from region. And this is why forward pointer allow us to simply change the value in the pointer, and well, nothing else. It's quite complicated because we need to use compare and swap operations, but I will tell you about it on the next slide. Well, how reading is performed when Shenandoah, when some thread moves the object? Reading is very easy, because we just need to use the value of a forward pointer to point to the right object and read the content of some object attributes. Writing is more difficult, because writing means that we need we are going to change the value of the object, for example, value of some attribute, and we need to write only to the object already moved to the region, not to this object. So writing this is the operation when these two copies of the original object are not to be the same. So it's a mutator. Well, and Shenandoah algorithm is based on these ideas. It divides heaps into regions of usually of the same size. There are no only two regions. There are no young and old. Nothing like this. There are only many regions of the same size. There have the same functionality. There are no distinguishing between young and old generation. The marking of a live object is run in concurrence to application thread. There's no big problem. So there are no stop the word behavior here. And then garbage collectors select some region which most garbage, and he tries to collect the object in this region by moving the object to other region which is which has enough free space. And this works in parallel. There are no only one region which is to be collected, but many regions, 8 for example. And we need to update the forward pointers. It's not done by GC threads here, but it's done by subsequent concurrent marking. So we go to the beginning and then we update updates all references which are in the previous step it reference to the old place of object, and we need to update it to reference to new place. And the evacuated regions are reclaimed and be free for another GC thread, for example. So how it look like? We have the classical heap, which is divided into regions. We have many regions. Now the one garbage collector threads find some region with most garbage. The red objects are garbage because they are not referenced from any stack, so they might be deleted. And the same thread select some region which is empty. So we are happy, we have empty region and a region with many garbage, and it simply moved the object to the empty region, and on the next concurrent marking it updates references to this object. So it looks easy, but it isn't in real world. We have the references to some object, and they are updated lazily when needed. For example, the region 2 is part to be collection set. It's to be compacted, which means that the object should be moved to another region. And we have two references to this object. So how to do it? A garbage collector or some mutator thread copies the object to the new region, but the references are still to the object B still points to the original place of this object. And after the next concurrent marking, these references are updated, and this object should be deleted. It's not needed anymore. This is in theory, but in practice, we need to solve the issue when application threads tries to read or write into objects, and at the same moment, the garbage collector threads are doing the marking and compacting work. Well, reading is simple because we can use the indirection through the forwarding pointer, nothing else. Reading is simple because reading doesn't make change in the object, so it's almost the same when we read from the old or the new copy of this object. Writing requires Java threads to move the object when it's not moved, which is interesting because this is usually the work for garbage collector threads, but in this situation, when the object is marked to be moved to another region, and Java thread wins to write to the object, it needs to do move and synchronizing. And there are problems when GC thread tries to copy the object into the new region, and at the same moment Java thread tries to update the object to write into the object attributes. And this can occur in parallel, and then GC thread updates the forwarding pointer to the wrong copy of the object, because both threads makes its copy, which is problem, and it's solved by using compare and swap. The both threads need to compare and swap the forwarding pointer to read the pointer and update it, but only one of these threads can succeed in this situation. When one thread don't succeed, it needs to use the new value of forwarding pointer to either update this copy of object or this copy of object. Only one copy is the object which to be referenced by other object. Yes, but it can do rollback. It can. This situation is solved by the compare and swap operation, because we can read the value of forward pointer and then compare it to the actual value.
Okay.
Yep. This is the. I think that there's answer for your question. Yeah, no problem. We have two threads. One read the object something from object A. The second write into the object A, and this can work in parallel. So we need to do compare and swap. One of these threads. Will win, and the other should copy or not. It depends. 5 minutes? 2 minutes. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Why is Shenandoah to say the best GC in the world? Not yet, but it's going to be. By the concurrent evacuation, the post times are very, very short, because the garbage collector threads runs in parallel with other threads. There are no needs to use remember set. It's not needed. Car tables are not needed too. And it's good for applications which are really optimized for running in long time, because in these applications the theory that most object youngs die might not be true, and it's truly adaptive. That's what I said. And no, there are no problems in Shenandoah. Yeah, what's left to do? Support for compiler. Compiler knows many things which may be useful for garbage collecting. there are problems with very large objects, which are larger than the size of the region. There may be some heuristic added into garbage collector. How many region to use, when to start concurrent marking, and so on. Instead of stop the application thread, it could be we can use round robin and blah blah. Yeah, compressed ops. It might be interesting to add support for compressed ops into Shenandoah to use the.
That's maybe useful. You've got 32 gigabytes or less of heaps.
So yes, right. Yeah, not for much machines, but. Let's see. Yeah, but it's not implemented yet. Well, that's all. Thank you.